us about the tour and what did you think of the damage?
Well, the first thing I'd like to say is this morning I had a chance to visit with our employees, and we have some incredible employees here, both at the National Park Service, but also at the U.S. Geological Survey. And I was able to commend the team that had spent so much time and effort up here during the event, making sure that folks were getting good information, good data, having that relayed down site. And so that was really great. The damage, you know, obviously, when an event of this magnitude occurs, things happen. And obviously, you all lived through an incredible period of that. And so what we're doing is looking at our facilities, asking ourselves, what potentially do we need to do, or what alternatives do we need to make? And those decisions are still a ways down the road.
But can you tell us how much money you'll be allocating for this park?
Well, so you know, the way that works is we go through a process with Congress, and we're in a process where I think they have found some money for the supplemental, but I never make a prediction on that until it's presented to the president. And but I do think the senators have been very responsive, and I think we'll be in good shape. We already have some resources from Federal Highways and others that will be coming in doing planning to deal with some subsidence and things like that at the park.
Do you have a sense, based on what you saw, that Jagger Museum would reopen? That's obviously a big attraction here. Is there any feeling?
So I think that it is very, you know, when you stand there at the caldera, my initial reaction, honestly, was there needs to be something there. It just seems like that would be counter purposes to not have something right near there. At the same time, there's movement on that ground. I mean, that's clearly obvious. It's still moving potentially. And so we need to think that through, because obviously safety is very first. But I think that that site is an incredible site, and we need to be very thoughtful about what we do there.
What stage in the rebuilding process are you in with HBO?
So in terms of rebuilding, I mean, I think the real issue is they have moved their facilities so that they can deal in a temporary situation. I think we're really fully operational at this point in time. But long term, you know, and that's what the employees need, is some long term certainty. And so I would think we're months away from making a very firm decision on that. But given where we are with the appropriation, I think that once we know what the appropriation is, then we'll be able to make a pretty sound determination.
The park is a big driver in the local economy, obviously, and attendance has suffered in recent months, I guess is the right way to say it. Is there anything that the government can do to expedite repairs here or to move up? I don't know, waiving procurement, any steps that can be taken to move things along?
So I think that you know, from the perspective of streamlining activity, the first thing is getting the appropriation, which looks like it's headed the right direction. And then I do think we have some ways to cut through some of the red tape. I mean, everything takes time when you're dealing with the government, in all fairness, but because we do have certain protocols we have to go through. But look, I wouldn't be here if I didn't think that this was going to be a priority, and that we were going to move forward as expeditiously as humanly possible.
Have you talked with the mayor and or the governor, and would your department help the communities outside the park?
So in complete candor, I haven't visited with the governor about this. I was actually scheduled to meet with him yesterday. My flight got delayed, I got to experience that. But I will be meeting with him, I think, at the Western Governors Association in a week and a half or so. Our role, and we play a very, we have a very close role with the local park here, and obviously the local community, the county, and we maintain that role. But generally, our focus is the jurisdictional area we're working within, and then how we can cooperate with others.
There's a strong sense locally that USGS, the observatory, belongs on this island, and I think some would say in this park. Can you speak to that?
Well, I don't think there's any issue, given the history of the U.S. Geological Survey being here, that it is a very fair statement to say that they certainly are very closely related to the island. We have not made the call on whether it'll be in the park or not, and that'll be a call that I'll be intimately involved in.
But you believe it'll be on the island?
Oh, I have a hard time believing it won't be.
Can you describe your impressions of what you saw today, just in detail? Did it impress you at all, the scale, the devastation, and where what needs to be done going forward?
So, I'm a guy from Western Colorado, you know, so anytime you come up and see a major volcano and see a picture of before, here's where the land was and after, it's a pretty significant event. And it's hard not to be standing there going, oh my goodness. What I really probably didn't appreciate before I got here, and this isn't something I witnessed, but the concept of the length of time that this event went on, and for not only our employees who are working here but also live here, but for your entire community going through the grind of that over a long period of time, in my mind, had to be a very significant thing. And I think I walk away with a much greater appreciation of that than anything else, honestly.
Well, after this tour and, you know, in your agenda, what's next for this park?
Well, you know, this park is a great asset. And so I think that we just need to make sure things are squared away. But from my perspective, it looks like revenues are starting to go up, visitations going up. It's interesting that I think if you look at this historically, when there's activity going on, that actually drives visitation up. And so it's hard to say, hey, there was activity and that's bad, when it also has it's also one of the reasons people came here as an attraction. And that's what I think they were thinking from the very beginning of the creation of the park, was, hey, this is an event that people want to see. And so we have to be thoughtful about that too.